Hi, I'm Mike Stewart. How you doing? I'm from North Granby, Connecticut. I specialize in tying flies that are typically wet flies, that's classic wet flies or nymphs. And in fact, today I want to show you how to tie the Tellico nymph. This pattern comes from the named after the Tellico River in Tennessee. The story is there was a priest in around 1927 developed the pattern. It's a great pattern. Most people think of it as an attractor type of pattern in the form of a nymph, but I tie it fairly heavily weighted and I fish it deep and I fish it very frequently. It's my go-to fly. I tie it in size 8s and only fish it in size 8s. So this is the Tellico nymph, and this is what it's going to look like when we're all done, but I wanted to give you an idea of where we're going to go. Again, it's a size 8, so I use a size 8 hook, and for purposes of this demonstration, I'm not going to bend down the barb of the hook, but what I do for my own flies, I do bend down the barb, and I do it before I tie the fly, just in case I end up breaking the hook, which is pretty rare, but it can happen. I start out with a white thread, one eye width behind the end of the shank. And the reason for that is I'm going to be using floss for the body. And you want to have a foundation that's a light color, so it'll bring out the color of the floss, if your floss is in itself rather light. And this is yellow, so it's one reason I'm going to have the white. If I had black floss, the blackness would come through and darken up the yellow floss. So I bring the thread, the white thread, it's 3/0 thread, fairly heavy, but it's a size 8 hook. And I bring it back to the end of the shank. I use 20 thou lead wire. The rule of thumb for wire is use the same diameter wire as is the diameter of the hook. And 20 thou pretty much matches a size 8. This is a 3906B mustad style hook. It's a 1x long nymph hook for a general classification. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. The reason I count is I find that 14 wraps of this lead wire centered right in the middle of the shank is in fact enough weight that I want to have. And I always have them 14 to be consistent. What I'm doing right now is I'm taking the end of the wire, just bending it over with the hard end of the half-inch tool, push it together, don't slip with the fingernails or you stab yourself with a hook. I use Sally Hansen's Hard as Nails fingernail polish to help cement down the wire. I use this form of Insta-Dry. I'm told it dries in about 75 seconds. But the point is, it dries fairly quickly. I don't have to wait all day for it to dry. Now I'm going to take the white thread and overwrap the lead wire with very large, widely spaced wraps, because I don't want the thread to go in between the wire wraps. So now I got it bound down. I'm going to make a little bit of a ramp with the white thread. And the reason for that is when I end up wrapping the floss for the body, I'll make a smooth transition from the diameter of the wire of the hook to the lead wraps. So now I have a ramp in the front. I'll do it in the back as well. This is an advantage of having a 3/0 thread here. It's fairly thick, so I can build the ramp up fairly quickly. So bring it back to the end of the shank, pretty much between the point of the hook and the barb. Now I'm going to make a tail. I use a tail out of a hen back. The hen back is mottled. It's brown mottled feather. Imitates the natural coloration of the insect life you find in the water.
I use the drop to soak.
Pull out the fibers, straighten them out, just rip them off the feather. Tail is short, it's only about half the length of the shank, measured against the hook. Tied in right where I left the thread. Do a pinch soft wrap. 2, 3. Trim it off. And now I'm going to tie in 9 fibers, again, a size 8 hook, 9 fibers of peacock curl. Tie them in at the tip end, but about an inch from the tips, because the fibers can be relatively delicate. Wrap them in, tie them in right on the top. Bring back the thread to my original tie-in spot for the tail. This is 4-strand floss that I use, and I'm only gonna need about 6 inches or so. I wet the ends just a little bit, makes it easier to manage. Just fold it around the thread, bring it right up to the fly. I remove the tension slightly from the thread and draw back the floss, and I'll just tie it in. I don't even have to clip the floss, I just tied it down with the thread. And I bring the thread back to right where I originally started it, and now I'm ready to make the body. Believe it or not, we're not far from completing this fly. I stroke the floss, get all the fibers nice and parallel with each other. That's key, otherwise your floss will spread all out. And I go from the right hand over the top to the left hand. I sort of call this like a relay. So I pass from the right to the left, right to the left. Make each wrap of the floss slightly overlapping, the previous wrap. And you see now I had a smooth foundation making up the thread to the lead wire, and now I got a nice tapered body. Some people refer to it as a cigar taper. Do about 3 wraps, nice and tight. Key in anything in fly tying is tight, lots of tension. Now I find one fairly full fiber hurl. I'm going to use that as a ribbing. So I make equally spaced wraps. People ask me how many, it's just equally spaced, probably 4, 5, 6 wraps. Bring it to the thread, tie it in, 2, 3. 3 wraps is plenty to tie it in. Now just before I bring over the shell back, I'm gonna tie in the throat. Now what I do here is I use the same hen feathers I use for the tail, and I'm going to select the fibers such that it's like 1.5 times the hook gap. And I'm only going to do 1 wrap, and that's key because you don't want it thick. Fish can't count, but they tell the difference between 20 and 8. So what I do is I remove all the fibers that I don't need to make that 1 wrap. So I stroke it back. And you can wet it if you wish. And I'm gonna cut like a little triangle shape, and I'm gonna tie it in right at the point that I just made, that little notch, if you will. So I do 1 wrap, then I pull the hackle out just a tad. And the reason for that is to expose some quill, so it gives me some room to pull out the feather, straighten it out, then start my wrapping without having those fibers going in the wrong direction. So I take the feather, bend it out towards me so the quill's facing me, take hackle pliers, and if your hands shake a lot because you're drinking a lot of coffee, I tell people take the tension off your quill, then grab it with the hackle pliers. Otherwise, you'll grab the hackle pliers, and inadvertently, you're gonna pull just when you clamp onto it, and you'll pull that feather out, and that's not good. So what I do is I wet my forefinger and thumb, stroke back on the fibers. You're not folding it like paper, but you're just sort of bending it back so it's leaning or tilting towards the rear. And I just wrap around until I've wrapped all the hackle on here, so it should be about 1 wrap. And tie it in, 1, 2, 3. And it slipped just a little bit, but that's okay. Because my mind is thinking is I need to go and tie this off and put on the black thread. So I'm gonna do one more wrap, and I do a 3-wrap whip finish, 2, 3. Find something pointy, draw it up. Cut the thread off, seems like it's a little involved, but it's important to use that white thread as an under or as a foundation. Tie in the black thread.
Nice meeting you too. Next time I come up, I'll stop by.
Now I'm going to stroke down these hackle fibers, sort of like down, and I don't have to worry about it going back because it's already pointing to back.
All right, take care.
Down.
See, like a case like that. Is that what I'm looking for?
Yep. Take my peacock curl and, like the floss, stroke it to get those all those little hurls nice and parallel to each other. Draw it right over the top. Keep it under tension. One. Two. Three. Now this black thread that I use is also 3/0. And all I gotta do is just finish off the head. Now I tell people that when you're doing the head, remember you're gonna do about 5 wraps of your whip finish, so keep that in mind. Don't finish the head and then do 5 wraps because you'll end up with a head a little bit too big. One, two, three, four, five, and I'm making each wrap right next to the previous wrap. Draw it up. Snug it. I use a knife to cut my thread because a knife will only cut what's under tension. Scissors, you can inadvertently cut your hackle that you're wrapped with. Sometimes you may have some items sticking out, as there is right now on that head. You don't worry. You just grab some pair of tweezers, grab a hold of it, pinch it, and it'll break right off right where you tied it in. So you get a nice, nice, neat cut. So you stroke down the fibers, make sure things are looking nice, you're happy with it, and you finish it up with a little head cement. Typically a whip finish is perfectly fine, you don't need really a head cement, but I like to put it on for people who watch me tie flies, or if I do them for presentations, or if I'm selling them flies. Just do a little dab. I rest my right hand against my left, just to reduce the shake. That becomes pretty important when you have small flies. Then one little dab, and we'll be done. I lied too. And that's it. One lovely Tellico. Cast this out fishing one nymph at a time, or sometimes you can tie it with another nymph or two other nymphs, cast two or three at a time. Fish this casting upstream, letting it dead drift, get onto the bottom, swinging up below you like the Lysering drift. Fish love it and they'll hit it really hard. There's no kidding around when a fish takes this fly.